It is a very personal film for me, although on the surface it might not look like it, because I'm originally from Iran, and the main character in this film is a boy from Chechnya. It's not even a girl. So it seems like maybe far away from me, but it is a very personal film. I emigrated with my family from Iran to Austria when I was 12. So I feel like this interest in portraying a child growing up between two cultures, with all the complexities that come with it, it's something very close to me. And the idea came about actually starting, the inspiration came from the place. There is this refugee settlement, the nickname is Macondo. It's on the outskirts of Vienna, and over 2,000 people from over 20 different countries live there. There have been generations of refugees over the past 60 years there. And so I heard about the place and I was intrigued and wanted to know what kind of people live there, what kind of stories they have, and started to do documentary research and decided very quickly to make it into a fiction and develop the screenplay out of that place. The original motivation was really personal. I was just in an emotional way interested in the story. But at some point when it became more reflective or like intellectual dealing with this, it was very important to me to have a change of perspective, because there are of course there are also other refugee stories, but for example, on Austrian TV or also in cinema, refugees or immigrants are always like side characters, or it's never their perspective, and I wanted it to be their perspective. It's funny that like all the main characters are refugees, and only the small roles are the regular Austrian people. And I think that's something that I had not seen before, at least in Austria. And I had this wish to just change the perspective. It's not even showing anything special. Just this change of perspective was important to me, to see, okay, this is how they look at this society, and not just we look at them, but just let them be the ones who look and have their point of view. First of all, it's just really about the human stories, and I'm not a journalist and I'm not a politician, I'm a filmmaker. So for me, it's just telling the story in an emotionally true way is the most important point. But of course I have an opinion about these things and I have my own personal experience. And I think this whole integration debate, sometimes it even makes me angry, because it's so black and white, and it's mostly about these people should finally adapt and integrate and assimilate. But first of all, you have to look at them where they stand and try to pick them up where they are, you know, and try to bring them into society. I don't want to judge about all European countries, because in different countries it may be different approaches. But what I experience in Austria is that there is always this demanding that these people finally assimilate or integrate themselves, but there is not much interest about their lives or where they stand at all. And I think especially these children growing up between cultures, this is such a huge chance. And the Austrian politics, they're not jumping at this chance. You know, who is jumping at this chance? It's, for example, religious radicals who, you know, lure these young boys into radicalized mosques and so on. Those people jump at the chance to pick up these boys in their search for identity. But the Austrian politics should do that. And because I think that boys or girls, like children in these communities, they are the mediators between their own culture and the new society. Just by the virtue of their biography they are, you know, there is nothing, they're not even looking for it, they are. They translate between their parents and the authorities, for example. They know both cultures, they navigate. I mean, I met and spent time with many youngsters, and they really very smoothly navigate between these different cultures. And I think that's the chance to just see what their problems are, where they're standing, where can you pick them up and just bring them into society and make them these bridges, and not just, you know, divide or just demand that they be part of society. This position of being in between and mediating, because I know it somehow from my own experience and from other people who are also migrants, it's just something natural we know from our lives. When I started to write about it, I started to analyze it, you know, before I didn't even analyze it. But of course I wanted to show how much responsibility and how much weight it puts on such a small child, because it's a lot of responsibility to be even taking care of the parents, you know, being the grown-up in the family. But then I thought, this is not only a burden, it's also a chance. You know, by reflecting it a little bit more, I started to think about it that way. And it was pretty obvious from the beginning. I mean, I knew that it was kind of a challenge to, you know, write a script that is, he's in every scene. We didn't have one shooting day without him. I mean, he had to be, we had to find this boy. It was not that easy. But I don't know, I had this kind of very strong feeling that we would find him because there are these boys with these biographies. So we just have to find the right one who has this kind of balance and is feels comfortable in front of the camera. And actually really like to work with children. I think there is a communication with them that's much more, much less intellectualized and much more direct than with grown-ups. He was very amazing from the first casting call he came to. We did different improvisations in casting, nothing from the film actually, because I wanted, I didn't give anyone any screenplay to read at any time. So I wanted to keep everything fresh for improvisation. So the scenes we improvised in casting were completely different things. But we did something where he has to, with some stranger, some woman who was enacting his mother, he's at the school and has to translate for the mother some mischief that he has, you know, he is responsible for at school. And the school principal says horrible things about him and he has to translate it back to the mother. And he was so amazing because he was lying to her and distorting things, and he was so funny and so tough and so sensible at the same time. It was clear that he was really good. But we called him back several times and tried different things until we were sure. But he was, I think it was pretty obvious from the beginning that he was very good.